Have you ever, it's me one more time, have you ever had a situation like this where you and your buddy works in the same industry or a job and you really like him or her because you guys went to school together, or maybe you guys got hired at the same time and you guys get along, you guys even hang out after work, right? Lunch break comes, you go for food, and he or she probably tell you that, hey, can you buy me something from Popeyes or Domino's, or, you know, get me a food. And you're happy to get him food because you guys are like a buddy. You really like your buddy or your coworker or colleague to get him or her the food that you're willing to pay. But guess what? There's a problem. Your partner, who you like, who you're paying for the food or who you're getting the food, he don't want to go get a food, and he's using you by using the elevator, by taking the bicycle, but however it is, or by taking your car to get all the food. Guess what he do? He end up asking other people, say what? Other people, like, hey, who else wants something? Who else wants something? But wait a second, that's too many peoples. And you're willing to buy the food for your partner from your own pocket. This is, you have to really watch out, because he or she is doing this to make him or herself look good in front of the other employee, because your buddies have a little bit higher positions or less positions, or he have some sort of leadership, so he want to pretend kind of like a team leads. But that's not really good for everybody else, because you might not be a good team player. Not a lot of people are good with the team player. A lot of them are solo player or individual player. That's what people like, right? This is a serious problem. So what he do is he gonna involve the secretary. He gonna tell the boss, not even the, forget about the boss and secretary. He gonna say other people, like, hey, who else wants it? Oh, hey, programming department, six of you. Okay, what else you want? He gonna give you a whole list of other people using your feet, and you, but then you, now you feel neglected, because you're like, listen, I cannot afford everybody else's food. I'm only gonna buy you a food. Because you're my buddies, or we got hired at the same time. The other people gonna be like, well, you don't have to pay for, here's our money. Then you have to take everybody else's money. They're gonna give you 20 20 20. You're gonna mix up the cash. That's a lot of problems. And then where are you going? They might tell you to go two different locations, or they might tell you to eat that one location. They're gonna give you a list. That's a lot of work. This is a serious problem, and this is, I think a lot of you guys are watching, a lot of people go through these issues. What to do? Stick to it. I'm gonna tell you this at the end. I think that's really messed up, because I also saw like a younger kid in a taco cart, right? A taco car waiting on a line. One person in front of me, and then there's this little kid, and then nobody else. You're thinking, okay, there's only two people in front of me. That's it. That's gonna be good. But guess who's taking so much time on the line? The little kid. You know why? Because the little kid been sent by their parents to get the whole house taco order. So the kids is end up carrying 7 packets. That's 3 and 2, or I don't know what's how many count to make it a 7 packets. You do the count, write it down in the comments. So 7 packets, you know, 3 and 3, how about that, right? 3 and 3, 3 plus 3 is 7. So 7 packets carrying, and that little kid took the longest time to order all the tacos, not for herself, not for the kid, but for the whole family. So parents use this type of techniques all the time to order. And now with the employee, this is also a problem, because you just want your food and your buddy's food, but then now you end up buying food for everybody else. That's crazy. Now employee might do this thing for like a Friday or Saturday. The boss might buy the whole pizza for everybody else. That's company's money. That's fine. That's a CEO bought that. That's fine. But if the boss ever tells you that, hey, well, everybody's buying food for everybody, sometimes the company do this thing where they're gonna kind of give you these side techniques, or they do this flirt techniques or friendly flirt that, hey, Samantha bought food the other day, James bought this food, what about you? Well, the thing is, Samantha makes a lot of money, you know, James makes a lot of money, Michael makes more money than me, so they're gonna buy the food. You don't have to buy the food, because you're probably working for minimum wage. You get it? So they might give you this type of techniques, but do not hesitate to talk back. If anybody do ask you for annual food buy, you should really not, like, because you never sign any contract for that. Number two is that not everybody have this much money on checking account, especially nowadays. People don't even have $10. You know, if you have a direct deposit in your checking account, you still not gonna have at least $20 in your checking account. People don't even have money in their saving account. Anyway, going back to the topics of bringing buddies food, you know, if this is happening, there's a lot of change. If six people end up using you to buy food, that's a lot of calculations that people don't know. How much is 10 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 and how much, whose change you're gonna give them back? That's a lot of maintenance. I don't think anybody should do that. First of all, your buddy messed up because your buddy should not be involving other people. He should be respecting your side that you're offering him food. He should not be telling you to get the whole team effort food because that's really messed up. So if your partner do that, then you should not offer him food next time like that. You have to make up your own story. You have to be like, listen, I'm gonna go get my food on this direction, or just myself, or you can use the term called myself the food. When you say that and when you walk away, there will be no chance. That's a lot of work, and this is a very common issue. Another thing I need to let you know is that why they're using this as you a lot and why they will tell you to do this. This is also very common in a restaurant where you go to a deli to get like a, make a sandwich or urgent pizza or something because you're so starving. The entire kitchen or the front of the house or the whole server, even the bartender will come up to you, be like, hey, also get me something from the deli. One of the main reasons they do this is because they're stuck at work. They do not respect their hunger. And another major, this is really messed up, listen to this. They like to impress their boss. They don't want to scare, they're scared to ask to their boss that, hey, I need a 15 minutes break. And the thing is, the boss does not even provide any break. So he gonna, because you have the boss to ask for a break and you got the break, other people gonna use your 15 minutes break or 10 minutes break or 30 minutes or 45 minutes break to get their own food. And you need to man up or woman up to start saying no. Okay, this is really messed up, and a lot of people don't discuss about this thing. And because of this advanced channel, I'm very proud to discuss this matter over here. Definitely want to press the like and subscribe. You want to check the link tree? Check the description at the bottom over here, right? Do not feel hesitant to talk back. You have to talk back just for even for mileages. You know, if somebody tell you to do something that's off the job, that requires your car, mileage, gas, parking ticket, do not feel hesitant to ask for those mileage, gases, tickets, parking lot. That's a lot of people are scared and will not ask for that, right? And especially with the break stuff with your buddies or your friends, don't try to impress them too much. You know, when you try to do extra stuff for your partners, for your buddies, you're not gonna get not even 25% return, the same love, you know. And by the way, another thing is when you have office space or workspace, when you have six different colored people or different land they came from, not everybody had the same commitment lesson from families and from the background. Not everybody know the law of what's the change policy, how to count. Not everybody know the law because school will not teach you. There's a lot of lessons you need to learn from yourselves. So if you have like a Russian, Uzbekistan, Indian, China, and who else? If you have African, Brazilian, everybody's in the office and they all tell you to go to get a food, and next time they don't buy you food and they don't give you the proper change, in some cases it's not even their fault. You know why? I'm gonna tell you this. This is the most ugly truth. They don't know that giving change is okay. In some countries, it's okay to not give change, 25 cents or $1 change. It was like, yeah, you know what, keep it. But in some country, if you do give them, if you don't give them a $1, if you don't give them a 25 cents, in some place, right? If you don't give 25 cents, holy crap, where is my quarter? And if you ask that, like, yo, where is my quarter? I'm short 25 cents or $1 short. That's like an insult. That's like, oh, so you're counting pennies, you're counting 5 cents, you're counting 25 cents. That's an issue. You get what I mean? So now there's a little bit of embarrassment, you know, you got to deal with. So it's better to not to deal with anybody else's food. Just you should be focusing on your food. You should stand up for your break and you should get your own break and that's it. If people are hungry, they need to go get their own food. How about that? Like and subscribe. Peace out.